yesterday we have studied about adjectives. Noun and pronouns we have already covered. Now today I am going to teach you comparison of adjectives. Why we need comparison? What is comparison? What are the degrees? How to form the degrees in comparative and superlative form? I am going to teach you today along with the exercise for your homework. So let's begin with it. So what are comparison of adjectives? Comparison of adjectives is when adjectives are used to show comparison of characteristics between two nouns or pronouns, it is called degree of adjective. What it is when two adjectives, when two nouns and pronouns are there and I want adjective to tell that what is more, what is less between these two, I tell them as degree of adjectives. For example, Ram is intelligent, but Rohan is more intelligent than Ram. For example, Ram is intelligent. Rohan is more intelligent than Ram, and Sohan is the most intelligent boy in class. So here what I am writing, that Ram is intelligent. So here what I want to know, yes, there is a boy whose name is Ram and he is intelligent. Here I am comparing Ram and Rohan, that between Ram and Rohan, who is more intelligent, either Ram or either Rohan. So Rohan is more intelligent than Ram. I want to know that it is of higher degree, the degree of intelligence, the quality of intelligence or the degree of adjective here is more than the first sentence. Whereas between all, if I compare, so I call it as positive, superlative degree, which is Sohan is the most intelligent boy in the class. He is the most intelligent boy. Now, one by one, we will study about the degrees. What are the degrees? How to form degrees? And what is the work of degrees of adjectives? I am going to teach you one by one Here, first one is positive degree. Positive degree shows the mere quality or by mere I mean ordinary. Ordinary quality of some person place or thing. If I consider an example here, so Sheena is beautiful. As yesterday we have studied, it is adjective of quality and Sheena is beautiful. I want to know that she is having a quality of being beautiful. Just beautiful. My another degree is comparative degree. By comparative degree, what I mean? It is used to compare two persons place or thing. How? Let's clarify it in example. Chapter 1 is easy and chapter 2 is easier than chapter 1. For example, another one I am taking here. Sheena is beautiful, whereas Veena is more beautiful. Then Sheena. So what I am doing here is that I have compared two things in both of the sentences. One is chapter 1 is easy. It is very easy. Whereas if I compare chapter 1 with chapter 2, chapter 1 with chapter 2, chapter 2 is easier than chapter 1. So here I am comparing two chapters. So comparative degree, it is used to compare two persons, place or thing. Now I am comparing here two persons. Sheena is beautiful. Veena is more beautiful than Sheena. What I got to know here is, in both of the sentences, one thing is very much clear, that both are having some quality. It is having the quality of being easy and she has the quality of being beautiful. Both are adjectives here, easy as well as beautiful. But if I compare it with another one, then I got to know that who is having more of the quality or less of the quality. In both of the sentences, let us consider sentence number 2. Sheena is beautiful. It is having the quality of being beautiful, but Veena is more beautiful. That is, it is having a great quality. It is having a higher level of quality. Now, one more degree is that positive and comparative we have already studied. One more degree is there, which is called superlative. In the articles, I have superlative meaning is that we use definite articles in it. So what is superlative degree? I am going to tell you right now. Superlative degree, it is used to show the bias form. It is used to show the bias form, that is between two people, between many people, or between many places, or between a group, who is having the highest degree of anything, that is called superlative degree. How? Let me tell you. Here again I am taking the same example. Chapter 1 is easy. Chapter 2 is easier than chapter 1, and the last thing is chapter 3 is the easiest one. So here I have three chapters in my book. I have to compare which chapter is easy than the another one. Chapter 1 is easy. It is having the mere of ordinary quality of being easy. Chapter 2 is easier than chapter 1. Here I have compared between two chapters, two things, chapter 1 and chapter 2. That is called the comparative degree. And chapter 3 is the easiest one. Chapter 3 is the easiest one among the whole. Now, if I change the example for the sake of your understanding, let's take another example of Sheena. Sheena is beautiful. Meena is more beautiful. Then Sheena. And Meena is the most beautiful girl. Here I am comparing three persons, Sheena, Meena and Meena. So when I say Sheena is beautiful, yes, it is having the quality of being beautiful. Now I have to use comparative degree. In comparative degree, always I need someone else. Always I need somebody else to compare with. I cannot compare a single thing. I have to compare two things. So Reena is more beautiful than Sheena. Whereas Meena, if I say that Meena is the most beautiful girl, it means whatever number of girls I have seen, Meena is the most beautiful girl among them. So it is called superlative. Now, how we form the degrees, formation of degrees, I will tell you. I form the degrees by adding general rules. To form degrees of adjectives. So what is the general rule? Degrees can be formed by adding ER or EST with the positive degrees. How? Let me tell you. Fine. I hope you have copied it. Now, I'm making here a chart. The very first and the very common one is, let's say this is positive degree. This is comparative. And this is superlative. I'm writing here positive degrees for you. First one is clever. Second, rich. Third one is strong. Now, as I told you in the comparative degree, I will put ER. So it is clever, rich, and strong. Again, I will write here clever, rich, strong. For the comparative degree, I add ER, and for superlative degree, I add EST. These words, when I add to the positive degree, they become comparative and superlative. How? Let's take the example clever. ER, ER, ER. And here EST, EST, and EST. So if I say Ram is a clever boy, clever is just the ordinary quality of being clever. But if I have to compare Ram with Shyam, so Shyam is cleverer than Ram. If I add ER, it becomes the comparative degree. When I add ER to the positive degree, it becomes the comparative degree. And if I want to tell that Mohan is cleverest among all the boys, so cleverest, I add EST, it becomes the superlative. Again, I am telling you the rule. With the positive degree, when I add ER, it becomes its comparative degree. And when I add EST, it becomes superlative degree. Same here, rich, richer, richest, strong, stronger, strongest. It is the very general rule that add ER with the comparative degree and add EST with the superlative degree so that you can compare between three degrees of adjectives. Now, next rule is for positive degrees that ends with E, P. Okay. Let me write it for you. If the positive degree ends with E, we just add R or ST. In the previous rule, we have seen that we add ER and EST, but because already E is the ending word, so I am not adding ER or EST in speed. I am adding R and ST. How? In the following table, in the following example, you will understand it in a very better way. Positive comparative and superlative. So let's write some degrees here. One is brave, another one is noble, and the third one is wise. So it is, you can see these all are ending with the E, ends with the E. Now I will just put R for the comparative degree. B, R, A, V, E, R, braver. N, O, P, L, E, R, nobler. And wiser. And S with the superlative. B, R, A, V, WISESTYZ. So if you see that red lower Y's are the positive degrees because it is ending with E. Because it is ending with E, I am adding only R with the comparative degree and ST with the superlative degree. Red, braver, bravest, noble, nobler, noblest, wise, wiser, wisest. So this is the thing. Now another rule I am telling you here. Rules are very important to learn in English grammar because grammar just runs on the basis of rules. It does not like if you are speaking it and you feel it is all right to speak. But rules are very important. So let me tell you the rules. Rule number 3 is if positive degree ends with Y, we remove the letter Y and add IER or we just add IER or IEST to form the comparative and superlative degree. How? Positive, comparative, and superlative. Let me write a few of the degrees. Easy, happy, heavy. You can see these all degrees are ending with the letter Y. So I remove here Y, E, A, S, R. It becomes easier. And in the superlative form, I again remove Y, E, A, S, I, E, S, T. Same goes with happy. H, A, double, P, I, E, R, happier. H, A, double, P, I, E, S, T, happiest. And happy becomes H-E-A-V-I, happier, and H-E-A-V-I-E-S-T, happiest. If you see, I have removed Y in both the comparative and superlative degrees, and I put I-E-R to form the comparative one, and I put I-E-S-T to form the superlative one. So easy, easier, easiest, happy, happier, happiest, happy, happier, and happiest. These are the general rules when the verb, when the adjective, when the word or adjective is ending with Y, we remove Y and add IER or IEST to form its comparative or superlative degree. Now, another one is when this is the second last one, I'm going to end the class. Another one says that is when the degree is of two slip, we add more and most. How? Let me tell you in the following example. Positive comparative superlative. Beautiful is again a positive degree. Difficult and faithful. Before making it, I must tell you that what is two syllable. When I say beautiful, and if you notice the movement of your tongue inside your mouth, try to speak in me beautiful. You will notice that your tongue touches the upper part of your mouth for two times. Beautiful, beautiful, difficult. Your tongue is touching the upper part of your mouth for two times. When the tongue touches your upper part for two times, it is called two syllable word. If I say easy, you will notice there is no touch of the tongue with the upper part of the mouth. Or if you say intelligent, then you notice that the tongue touches upper part of the mouth for the two times. Or let's say if you say heavy, then you notice tongue is not touching. Try to speak with me. First word is easy, easy, easy. You notice that the tongue is not touching the upper part of the mouth. Now say heavy, heavy, heavy. Again it is not touching. But if you speak beautiful, beautiful, you will notice that tongue touches. Or difficult, again the tongue is touching. Or say faithful, you see, you notice the movement of your tongue, that is called two syllable word. If the tongue is touching, it is called a two syllable word. So how to form it? For comparative, I add more. In all the comparative degrees, I write more, and it is most. And simply put the positive degree here. More beautiful. More difficult and more faithful. Again, beautiful. Again, difficult. And here again, faithful. So this is lesson for the day, and specifically I am telling you your homework. We are going to start the exercise and we are going to fill the proper adjectives in their proper degrees tomorrow, because we have less time in the online classes. So not to make it a very large class, it is a small class, and two more rules are there to form the degrees. It is just, I have told you just four rules, two more are there, which I am going to tell you tomorrow. Your homework is to write all these rules in your notebook and to learn all the rules. That is your homework for the day. That is all for the class today. Stay blessed. God bless you. Thank you, students.